In this section, all we've done is introduce some initial properties for differentiating functions more quickly. We'll need to get more complex properties and continue establishing some more ideas before we can differentiate any function we might come up against. But there's a wider array of functions that we'll be able to differentiate now than might immediately be obvious. So what we can look at doing is taking a given function and rewrite it in an equivalent form in order to match the properties that we've established so far. So in example 6, we want to take each of the functions below and rewrite it with negative exponents, so that then it will match one of the properties that we've already established. So our function 9 over 2x, 2x to the fourth could be rewritten as 9/2 x to the negative 4, or another way to write it would be 9x to the negative 4 over 2. So both of these are equivalent expressions. This one's maybe a little more simplified because we get that constant multiple set aside. But if we make that exponent negative by bringing it up to the by bringing that variable up to the numerator, now we can find f prime of x using a power function, because that's all this is once we do that simple rewrite. So this will become 9/2 times negative 4 x to the negative 5th, or negative 18 x to the negative 5th. So we could leave our answer like that, or we could go ahead and move that x to the negative 5th down to the denominator to rewrite it with a positive exponent, to write it as negative 18 over x to the 5th. We can do the same thing in part B. In this case, the first term doesn't need to be rewritten unless we do want to rewrite it to set apart that constant multiple. So this would be 2/5 x to the 3rd minus 4/7 x to the negative 3rd. So by rewriting that x to the 3rd in the denominator as x to the negative 3rd, again we have a power function, and we can find the derivative of g of x very simply. So this will be 6/5 x squared plus 12/7 x to the negative 4. Or again, if we want to rewrite this with positive exponents, we could rewrite it as 6x squared over 5 plus 12 over 7 x to the 4th. So rewriting things with negative exponents is one trick to match these properties we've already established. Another is to take radicals and rewrite them with rational exponents. So a function like 9 times the square root of x can be rewritten as 9x to the 1/2. So again, we have a simple power function to differentiate. This would become 9/2 x to the negative 1/2, or 9 over 2x to the 1/2. If we make that a positive exponent, and then if we wanted to, we could even turn that back into something with that radical notation to write it as 9 over 2 root x. In part B, we have 4 over the cube root of x squared, which is the same thing as 4 over x to the 2/3, which is the same thing as 4 times x to the negative 2/3. And again, we've got a power function. So we get g prime of x is going to be negative 8/3 x to the negative 5/3, which we could rewrite as negative 8 over 3x to the 5/3, or negative 8 over 3 times the cube root of x to the 5th. So look at rewriting things with negative exponents. Look at converting radicals into rational exponents. Those are two tricks. Another that we can apply in example 8 is to expand a given function. So 3x minus 6 squared, we don't have a derivative property to attack that directly, but if we realize that this is just the same thing as 3x minus 6 times 3x minus 6, then we can expand that into 9x squared minus 36x plus 36. And now we can take the derivative term by term of these power functions and this constant. So this will give us 18x minus 36. The last type of rewrite we want to look at is looking at writing some rational functions as the sum or difference of multiple rational functions. So for instance, an expression like 17x plus 32 over x, we could break this up as 17x over x plus 32 over x. And we know that these two expressions are equal because here we have two functions or two terms with common denominators. So we could add these two terms together and get back to what we started off with. So a little bit of reducing, x over x will cancel, this will be 17. And then we could rewrite this as 32x to the negative first. So f prime of x will be the derivative of 17 is 0. So we get negative 32x to the negative second, or negative 32 over x squared. Similarly, in part B, we can write this as 5x over 45x cubed minus 9 over 45x cubed. So as long as we just have one term in the denominator, we can always break that up. And this will reduce to 1 over 9x squared minus 1 over 5x cubed. Which would be 1 ninth times x to the negative 2 minus 1 fifth x to the negative 3. So again, each of these rewrites so that we get either a single power function or the sum and difference of multiple power functions, which we can apply these properties now that we've established. So this will become negative 2 ninths x to the negative 3 plus 3 fifths x to the negative 4. Or again, we could rewrite this as negative 2 over 9x cubed plus 3 over 5x to the fourth. So when we start off with a function that looks a little more complex, we want to think about how we can rewrite that to break it down to match some of the simple properties we've established so far.